So one of the things that I see out there is everyone is like doing launches, live launches and email launches and product launches, all of this stuff. And here's what I want you to understand. Super, super high ticket clients, like $15,000 to $200,000 plus types of clients, don't go into launches. And I'm not saying some of the $15,000, you might be able to get some of them, but here's the thing that you need to understand about high ticket clients is they don't buy like that. High ticket clients are very, very quick to make decisions. If they're looking for something, if they're looking for something that they need or someone that can solve a problem for them or help them with what they need, they start looking for that person. So they're not going to go through a 5-day launch or whatever it is. They don't have time for that. High ticket clients value their time more than they value money. And so one of the reasons people don't attract higher ticket clients is because they don't understand them. They don't understand how they buy, they don't understand what they want, and they don't understand how to really leverage social media and the internet to attract those clients to them and to get those clients. Okay, so the first thing is you have to understand how they buy, okay? And high ticket clients do not go through funnels. They don't go through launches, and a lot of times they don't respond to paid advertising. Okay, that's just not typically, because a paid advertising is typically going to take you through a funnel, right? You opt into some little bitty course, maybe some $27 thing or something like that. So high ticket clients aren't going to respond to those types of things. What they are going to do is they're going to seek the person that they're looking for that can help them with what they want. And so you've got to really understand their buying pattern and what makes them make decisions. Now, they'll make decisions on a few things. First of all, they're going to check you out, okay? If they come across you and they see what you do and they have a need for what it is you do, then they are going to go check you out and you're never going to know that it's happening. So what does that mean? That means that your internet presence, that means that your social media has to be dialed in to speak right to them. It has to show you as an authority in the marketplace for what you say you can do. It has to show you as an expert for what you say you can do. It has to show credibility. It has to show social proof that you are good at what you do. All right. And so if you don't have these pieces dialed in, if you don't have your online presence, if it doesn't look, if you don't look like the expert, like you don't have a book around that topic, around that subject, or you have never been featured as a speaker, or they can't see really any kind of digital presence from you other than you just, showing up, then that is not necessarily going to build that credibility to make them want to buy from you. And high ticket clients will just book on your calendar. It's the craziest thing. They'll never engage. You won't even a lot of times know that they exist. They will just book on your calendar, or someone will refer them to you. And here's what is important about this. You want them to see what you want them to see. Okay? So when I say that, you have to make sure that without beyond the shadow of a doubt, they can check you out all day long and they're going to see the same thing over and over again. That's going to build the credibility. All right? Super, super important. So if you don't have any testimonials, any social proof, if you don't have your website set up in the right way, if you don't have your digital assets, your Facebook page, your LinkedIn profile, all of your social media set up in the right way, if there's a disconnect in the things that you're talking about, you won't attract them. They want specialist, they're looking for the expert, they're looking for the person who can solve their problem. I cannot tell you how many times I've had someone book on my calendar that came across me somewhere in some of my content, and they would say, "Ann, I don't even know how you showed up in front of me." Well, I know how I showed up in front of them, which I'll share with you, but I don't even know how you showed up in front of me. I don't know how I haven't heard about you before, but I knew when over the weekend I literally went and checked you out everywhere. I consumed your content, and I know you're the person that can help me. I mean, I have to tell you, there is no better sales conversation than when someone's ready to buy, right? When someone books on your calendar, you're on a call with them, and they are like convinced that you are the person that they need to hire. I mean, there's no better sales conversation, right? So that's really what I'm talking about. I'm talking about really getting in front of the people that you want to serve, in front of the people that you want to help, and show up in a super big way. This is one of the things that I help my clients do. Because I help coaches, consultants, professional service providers stand out as the expert that they are, get and or demand and get higher ticket clients. This is all a big piece of it that we have got to dial in. We've got to get them positioned right in the marketplace. So we will do things like I'll get them on a magazine cover. I'll get them on a syndicated podcast across 280 channels. We'll do a press release. We'll get a book for them. It's a whole package that goes into helping them be able to do this. And then I show them how to build that online presence in such a way that their ideal clients will just come to them. Now, here's why you don't need the launches, okay? If you can show up in a way that can give massive value and educate your client about exactly what you do in great detail, they will typically buy. They'll buy. They don't need to go through a 5-day launch. They don't need to be put into a Facebook group and nurtured. They typically will buy. Okay? Now, everyone is not at this place, right? So everyone is not ready to buy right now, and that's where all the nurturing comes in, and that's where, build your community. You always want to build your community so that you have this pool of people that you're nurturing along until they are ready. But what I want you to understand is that when a super high ticket client is looking for something, they're looking for something, and they come across the answer to that problem, that pain, that result that they want, that outcome that they want, they don't have to go through funnels. They just want to check you out, and they want to see that you can do what you say you can do. That's it. It's that simple. They're actually so much simpler to sell to and to really like bring on as clients than most people. And so it's a really important piece that a lot of people are missing. So the first way to leverage the internet and social media to get high-paying clients without exhausting launches and paid ads is to show up as the expert, get positioned as the expert that you are, and then you've got to have a strategy in place, a marketing strategy, so that people can easily see you everywhere. They can see you all over the place. They can see what you're all about. There's no doubt in their mind by the time they check you out. If you go to my website, a good example of this, and here's the other thing. I hear a lot of people say, you don't need a website. Bull. That's bull. I'm going to call garbage on that. You don't need a website if you're marketing to coaches on Facebook. Okay, you don't need a website. But if you're marketing to high-ticket clients, if you are looking for those premium high-ticket clients that are like, I hate to say real clients, but I mean super high-ticket, if you're marketing to other people, you have got to have a website. Now, I'm not selling you a website, okay? But I am going to tell you how to set it up. So you've got to have a website that shows you as an authority, as an expert for what you do. Because people that buy professional services, the first thing they're going to do is check your website. They're not going to go to your Facebook page. People that are very high ticket are not going to go to your Facebook page first. They're going to first look at your website and they're going to see what you're all about. Okay? So for people to tell you don't need a website, they're playing in a small pond. They're playing low level. All right. And so you'll see that a lot on Facebook. I see that with a lot of coaches. They're going, no, you don't need a website. No, you don't if you're selling a 297 course. Okay, you don't. You don't need it even if you're selling a $5,000 program on Facebook. You don't need a website. Okay, you can just do that on Facebook. You can do that with live launches. You can do that with paid ads. I'm not talking about any of that. I'm talking about bringing in premium clients. Okay, so your website has to position you as the expert. So if you go to my website, you're going to see my books on there. You're going to see the fact that I've been a speaker. You're going to see pictures of me on a stage, right? You're going to see my headline, what I help people do, what I'm all about. You can go if they want to go check out free resources. Those free resources are on there for them to check out. There's going to be a blog that talks about all the things that I talk about. There's going to be I will drive them to my YouTube channel where where they can go check me out. So my, even if they just go to my website, it will take them anywhere they need to go. It will take them to my LinkedIn profile. It will take them to my YouTube channel. It will take them to my Facebook group or my Facebook profile. It will even invite them into my Facebook group. All of these things are part of my website. I will even ask them if they want to opt in for something free. So if they want to go through my four-step video series on how to build a $500,000 coaching and consulting business. Now, also, or how to, you know, get positioned as the expert. All of those things are on my website, okay? And so it's one stop, and then they can find out everything that they need to know about me. I also have on there where I've been featured in the media. I show media features. I show syndicated podcasts that I've been on. I show magazine covers. All of those things are part of the positioning that I have on my website. But they're also things that I share across the internet, where people can see me across the internet in all of these ways. I also have a podcast where people can watch me interviewing other people. And so that's, again, another positioning thing. So they can go check out one or two podcasts, and they will clearly be able to see that I know what I'm doing in business, in marketing, in sales, because those are the people that I interview. And then there's always a way that I can interject my expertise into those interviews and that I can share. So all of those things, it's you've got to establish that in the marketplace if you're looking for these premium high-end clients. Okay, so step number one is your positioning. All right, step number two, and how you can leverage the internet and leverage social media to get very, very high paying clients, is to look for partnerships and strategic alliances. Okay, so one of the things that I do is I look for, okay, who else has my ideal clients? Who else is in front of them? All right, how can I leverage their audience? How can I leverage their people? How can I maybe even leverage their clients? And so I use it in a strategic way to also use other people's audiences. Now, they're not my competition. I look for people who are not my competition, but they serve the same people. So this is step number two on how you can use the internet. Now notice, nowhere in here have I talked about launches. Nowhere in here have I talked about paid ads. This can all be done organically. Now you can use some systems. I use LinkedIn. I have a system that I teach my clients, and I use LinkedIn. And for example, when I wanted to get people on my podcast, I sent out one message and I had over 100 replies of people that wanted to be on my podcast. And it literally took me 10 minutes to set it up. So, but here's the reason that happened, because I was positioned as the expert. I didn't look like some spammer out there. I was positioned as an authority. And so very, very high level people were connecting with me saying, I would love to be on your podcast. So that's all part of this. If you don't want to have to run, now I'm not against paid ads, right? But you've got to be able to do all of these things before you put any money into paid ads, because if you can't do all of this organically, paid ads are not going to work for you. They're not going to work. You've got to get all of these things in place first, okay? All right, the third way that I leverage social media and the internet is I build my list and I curate my audience and my community, all right? And I don't do paid ads to do that. I do all of that organic. So when I'm putting out content, I typically have a call to action. My goal is to bring people into my ecosystem, okay? Now, a lot of times those people are ready to buy right now, all right? But sometimes they're not, and they have to be nurtured. And so I want to bring those high-value clients into my ecosystem in some way. Now, will they necessarily be hanging out in my Facebook group? No, probably not, because high-ticket clients are typically super busy. They don't have time for that, but I still want to get them on my email list. I still want to get them into a relationship with me. That's why I love my podcast, because it allows me to be able to build that relationship with them, and they may at some point may have a need for my services, right? But none of this is paid. None of this is paid. It's all organic. And so I cross-pollinate my content from one platform to the next. I always have a strategy in place. Everything that I do is strategic. Everything. Every piece of content I put out is strategic. It's driving people to think how I want them to think about what I want them to think about. It's shifting beliefs. It's driving them to want what I have. It's driving them to want to work with me. That is the purpose of all of my content. Now, sure, I do things that are personal. I'll put out, you know, content pictures or little videos of my triplet grandkids that are 4 years old, triplets. And I love sharing that because what does that do? That gives insight as to who I am as a person, okay? I've been married for 39 years. My husband and I will celebrate 40 years this year. And I will put pictures of my husband and I up, and I'll talk about the fact that we've been married for 40 years. Because, again, does that build credibility? Does that build trust? Does that build authority with my ideal clients, even though I'm helping them with business, marketing, and sales? Yes, yes, right? There's credibility to that. And so I want them to see who I am as a person. You know, a couple years ago, I went skydiving with my son, and it was such an incredible experience. I wanted to do it for a lot of years, and he finally just booked it for Mother's Day, and we did it as a mother-son thing, and it was so much fun. And he bought me the whole media package, so I've got videos of me skydiving in the air, you know, doing a heart, and I've got pictures in the air and all of that, you know, through the whole thing. And I have used those pictures on social media talking about skydiving. I've even made it relevant to, you know, building a business is a lot like jumping out of a plane and then, you know, building the business on the way down, right? You hear that all the time. And so I've made my content relevant to my business. So all of it grabs attention, right? All of it grabs attention. But I don't just want to do that. The whole idea of content, the whole idea of online marketing is to pull the right people into you. Get the people that really align with you and go, oh, that's so cool. I like Anne. I really like her. I like her as a person. I like what she stands for. All of that is part of your branding. It's all part of your personal brand to attract your ideal clients. Because you are looking for people. And in a lot of cases, this is the interesting thing. Most of the time, we're looking for people who are almost like us, or they resonate with us. They align with our values. They align with our goals. You know, when I work with someone, I look for leaders to work with. I look for people who are like leaders. They have all this massive expertise. I'm talking about like coaches, consultants, professional service providers. I want to work with people who are leaders. They, you know, they're showing up. They're bold. They invest in themselves. They have a growth mindset. Those are all characteristics of the people that I'm looking for, because those are the people that I know are going to get results if I work with them. I'm looking for the people who maybe are just stuck. They've invested and they've tried other things and they've done a lot of other things, but it hasn't worked for them. Those are my people, and I'm very clear about that. And I'm very clear about saying, if you don't have an expertise, you need to go get good at what you do before I can help you build your business. I'm very clear about that. Now, there are a lot of other coaches out there that love to help people build a business with no expertise. Okay, that's not me. So all of your branding, all of your marketing, everything, all of your content, everything that you put out there should be super, super clear to your ideal clients so that they know what they're buying. They're buying the result and the outcome that you can help them get, but they're also buying into who you are as a person and what you stand for. Okay, I have no problem telling people, go check me out. Just go Google me. You know, you'll get pages of stuff. And I have two websites. Go to my websites and look at the testimonials. And if that's not enough for you, I'll send you more and I'll send you case studies. Because there's so much stuff that's not even on my website because it would just get ridiculous. Okay, because I've been doing this almost 10 years and I've been building businesses for 29 years. And so there's a lot. There's a lot of stuff that I have that I can't put it all on my website, right? You've got great advice about positioning and connecting with other strategic. Yes, but here's the thing, and this it goes back to this. People will connect with you. It's very seldom I don't get people to connect with me unless they feel like I'm a competitor. You know, if they feel like, which I wouldn't don't connect with those people anyway. But if they felt like I was competition to them, I wouldn't probably get a connection with them. Okay? But people who connect with me, they look at me and they go, "Oh, she's the real deal. Like she knows her stuff and she looks like an expert, and she looks like a higher level person." And that's what I want them to see, because that is who I am, right? I've got a lot of experience. I'm not just a one trick pony. I'm not just, you know, a jack of all trades. I have a lot of valuable experience and knowledge. And so I want them to see that. I talk about the fact all the time that I've built six businesses and I've sold five. That's huge. Most businesses fail. 80% of businesses fail, 90% in 10 years. So the fact that I've built multiple businesses and sold them is a massive credibility. It doesn't matter if it was in their industry or not, it still holds massive value. The fact that I've written three books, that has massive credibility, right? The fact that I speak on stages, or I speak, the fact that I get on other people's podcasts as a guest, all of those things are part of a credibility builder. You know, being featured on magazine covers, being featured in magazines with articles, all of those things are things that I've done. And so that's all a piece of what you want people to see about you. If you want high ticket clients, you've got to get all of this dialed in. Now, notice I did not say launch. I didn't say do launches. I didn't say like put them through a 5-day training in your Facebook group. No, that's not how they buy. It isn't how they buy. It's not what they're looking for. And so if you don't understand how your high ticket clients buy, or what they're all about, or the emotion that they go through, or you don't really have all these things dialed in, you won't get them. Now, the third thing that I want to talk about, let's see, get positioned. Look, leverage the internet and social media to get strategic partnerships. You can also use them to get on stages, right? Get speaking engagements. Reach out. You can get people that you can get to people that you've never been able to get to before. All right, with the right strategy, you need a strategy behind everything you do. So you can also get those really high level people that you want to get to, but you haven't been able to. Like a typical marketing thing wouldn't do it, right? And so you can leverage social media like that. Finally, you can leverage social media by asking, you know, looking to see, okay, who else knows who I'm trying to reach? And can they introduce me? Now, again, if you're not positioned right, is that person really going to want to introduce you? No. But if you're an expert, if you look like a specialist, if you look like the go-to person, people will refer you. They'll be like, "Yeah, I'll be happy to make that connection for you." Okay? So you can leverage social media and the internet in that way as well. All right? So all of these things are pieces of what need to be dialed in if you want to show up and really get those better clients. If you want luxury clients, you've got to look like a luxury brand. You've got to show up and speak. You know, your ideal clients are, again, are going to be a reflection of you. The other piece that I want to talk about is you're not going to get these types of clients, $15K to $200,000 clients, if you're not growth minded, if you don't invest in yourself, if you don't invest in your business, if you don't invest in your own growth. And that is as honest as I can say it. Okay, because when I see coaches and consultants who go, "I don't know why I'm not getting high-end clients," I go, "Well, what was the last thing you invested in that was high ticket?" And they go, "No, okay, yeah, good luck with that. Good luck. It's not going to work." Because high ticket clients want to know that you're the same person they are. They want to know you're growth minded. I had a coach years ago, 10 years ago, when I first started coaching and consulting, and she was a client, and she said, "The one thing that made me choose you is because you mentioned that you have worked with coaches and that you even currently still work with a coach." Okay, so that's what they look for, right? Because those are the people they are. That's what got them to where they are. They have the money to invest in you because they're doing some things right. What do you think they're doing right? And then what aren't you doing to get those people? So this is all a part of you know, sort of the entire process or the entire strategy around getting these premium clients. And a lot of people don't get this. They think it's as simple as raising your prices. It is not as simple as raising your prices. You know, when I work with my clients, we have to restructure the value of what they're selling. We have to restructure their offers. If they want to go from, I think about one of my clients, $9,600. If she wanted to go from $9,600 as her high ticket program, which is kind of what you see all over Facebook, and now she wants to get $45,000 clients and $34,000 clients, which are the two offers we put together for her. Now we've got to change a lot of other things too. She can't just raise her prices that much and go, okay, here I am. No, we had to change her ideal clients. We had to change her marketing. We had to change her branding. We had to level her up. We had to level up her sales process. We had to get her to really understand the value of what people are buying from her. All of that is part of getting those higher value clients. She went out and had a new photo shoot done that aligned with who she was trying to attract. She had a new website built, you know, that leveled up her brand and made it look like she was ultra successful, which she was, but her brand wasn't reflecting that. And so all of this is part of getting those high value clients. This all builds your credibility. This all builds your authority. And then you've got to show up and show them that you really can do what you say you can do. All right, I don't even have time to recap. I am out of time here. But if you have any questions, drop them in the comments. And what would you like to charge? I say to people, you can charge whatever you want. Whatever you want to charge is what you can charge. As long as you're good enough and you can create your business model in the right way, you can build your business in the right way that shows the value and you're positioned in the right way so that those premium clients will pay you happily and be excited to pay you. If you put all those things together, you will be able to charge whatever you want for what you are delivering. It has to be the value of what you're asking, right? I mean, that all is part of it, but you can charge whatever you want. If I wanted to go out and charge $100,000 to a client, I would put together my $100,000 offer. I would discover, okay, who's the person that I want for this offer? Who's my perfect ideal client? And I would get positioned in the marketplace to go and get them. All right, and I would bring them into my ecosystem and I would connect with them and I would make sure that they saw what I wanted them to see so that they would know I was the person that they should hire for this thing. And that's exactly what this is all about. So, if you don't like launches, if you feel like you're not getting those high value clients, if you feel like you're tired of this whole thing, but you're really good at what you do. You can deliver results. You can, and if you're not, then you've got to go get good. Okay, that's it. That you've got to go get good. There are so many people on Facebook I would never, ever, ever hire for my business because I don't believe them. I think they learned to do one thing and now that's what they're selling. And that's what you see a lot on Facebook. And that's why a lot of people get ripped off. That's why a lot of people are frustrated with what they're buying into. If I put up a post in my Facebook group this morning and I said, if I would never, ever, ever hire a business coach who is not built as success, who has not built actually several successful businesses. If they've only been successful in the one business that they've got and that's all they've done, they're not going to be the right person, okay? And so this is how high ticket clients buy. This is what they're looking for. I want to know that you really can do what you say you can do. So I'm Ann Carden. I hope this all helps you. How did you become an expert at your topic? Oh, that's such a great question. So how did I become an expert? In consulting and coaching and what I'm helping people do right now, it's a combination of 29 years of building businesses. I was also 13 years in corporate running multiple million-dollar departments in a multi-billion-dollar organization. Left that after 13 years, started building my business 29 years ago, built six businesses from the ground up. I had a global business. My first business was global and went worldwide without the internet. I didn't even have this. So I had to do things the old-fashioned way. But I was basically running a manufacturing company out of my home. I employed several people. I ran that business for 7 years and then I sold it. And then I started my second business. And this is my sixth business that I have right now. And all of the other five I've been able to sell. Now, I've learned a lot of hard lessons along the way. I've made a lot of mistakes. I burned up, I talk about the fact that I burned up hundreds of thousands of dollars in marketing. And so I had to become good at marketing. And I put in the money and I put in the time and I worked with the best people. And through the process, I've also made a lot of mistakes in the people that I hired, especially when I came into my coaching and consulting business. I hired a lot of the wrong people. I made a lot of the mistakes. I found out that most people aren't very good at what they do, and I burned up a lot of money. Okay, now did I cry about it? No. Did it suck? Yes. Okay, but I learned a lot through it. And through all of that investment, I probably invested hundreds of thousands of dollars over 10 years in my coaching and consulting business to learn what I've learned. And through all of that, I've put my own process together, and I know what works and I know what doesn't work. And then I've also got all of the massive business experience and sales and marketing experience through all of those years that also I am able to bring into my process, and other people don't have that. They just don't have it. So I hope that helps. I've also, written books and I speak. I 10 years ago, I was running marketing boot camps and marketing seminars and marketing workshops to teach people how to build their personal brand. And I would tell insurance agents, and this is if you're still on here as a realtor, I would tell the realtors and the insurance agencies, look, you are your brand, not Farmers Insurance, not State Farm. You are your brand. If you ever decide to leave that company, you don't want to leave all that you've built behind. You want people to want to follow you. You are your brand, okay? If you are a professional service, you are your brand, even if you have a company. Now, if you're looking to sell that company at some point, then, that's a whole different thing, okay? Then you have to build the company brand. But as a professional, we are our brand. And so that's what people are buying into. So I am out of time. I have to honor the time in here. But thank you for being on. Listen, follow me. Come follow me. Connect with me if you want to level up your brand. If you want to get those premium clients. If you want to be seen as the expert. I have an Expert in You Business Mastermind, Business Accelerator Mastermind program that I'm only taking 6 people for. If you're ready to really step into a brand new level, multiple 6 or 7 figures in your business, reach out to me. Let's have a conversation about that. Okay. Is there an investment? Yes. You've got to be willing to invest in your success. If you want very high ticket clients, if you want better premium clients, and you're not willing to make an investment, and I'm not saying this to make you feel guilty, please don't misunderstand. I'm not trying to do anything slimy here. It's just the way it is. If you don't know how to do that, then you need to invest to learn how to do that. Okay. All right, ladies, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure. And I also have a Facebook group. Come join me in my group. I do stuff like this all the time. I have great interviews in there with experts. You can get massive, massive value out of that group. So come follow me. Come get into my group. Thank you so much for being on. You guys have an amazing day. I love you. God bless you all. Bye-bye.